I wonder how many levels this actually has. Because this shows that there is... Well, that has the whole UFO, by the way. That's pretty cool. And kinda looks like the one of the Thor movie ships, to be honest. But there seems to be 5 levels in total in this map, so that is the 5th level. So basically there could be 4 levels in this UFO. And there probably is 4 levels in the UFO. Slap some paint on it and call it good. Yeah. Just use Aritani. Why not? No need for anyone else to shoot, just send in Aritani, shoot in the head with the shotgun, you're good. Early game of Nomoria and both of your soldiers are sleeping during first coupling attack. Sounds perfect. Oh, hello! Ah, 2 time units. Crap. Well, close the door. Almost enough time units to actually shoot, but no. Yeah, it could be actually a good idea on here is to reload with some people. Shame the tank cannot drive through the walls. Would be handy. Is there a back door? Wait. I guess not. Oh. I think these armors actually don't jump over anything, they just walk through. Hey Zorfos. Ouch. Why did you shoot when the alien opened the door? Yeah, and here is. Ah, the Dogman is bleeding. That's good. So there is a... 2 teleporters here, it seems. Dapper Dogman wants revenge. And he's blind. Yep, walks through the doors. And I think he... Let me try with this guy, Paizo. If I walk through that... Yep! So this is the Predator armor for the heavy weapons. And they just... walk through everything as well, like the tank does. They don't climb over or anything, they just roll through. Next level. Dark and Ram of First Blood. Yeah, pretty much. Those Predator armors are so nice. I just need to get the better heavy weapons. I'm using the laser and the other garbage, the basic one, and I really need to get the high level versions. Lemorn. So there's gonna be some kind of leader alien on this ship on the higher levels. Probably somewhere up here all the way. Which I really need to capture. Split tank to guard. So no one comes in. So the, I think I need the leader to unlock the last mission. Whoa! What's that? Oh, that's a rookie. Alien rookie. Red shirt. But what the hell was that in the... in there? That's something new. Also, this alien is not the most clever. Let's use dark. Oh, managed to suppress Aritani. Good job. Oh. What do you see? Oh, you see someone all the way there. Nice. Can you shoot through here? Well, at least the alien gun. And then it broke my cover totally. Close the doors. Well, I should just go in, I guess. We need to keep this, whatever it is, intact. I think this is probably gonna unlock something new. Those one of those alien red shirts was really epic hero in one of the base assault missions. He just decided to shoot a stack of rockets in my base and pretty much killed half of the aliens with the explosion. What is the state of this game still in alpha? It's still in alpha at the moment, Storm of Blood, but it is feature complete at the moment, and it's supposed to fully release at the end of this month. So, a couple more weeks, and the game will be actually fully out. They are basically doing a... was it 8 weeks, 6 weeks of balancing and getting rid of bugs and all that. Now. So you can play through the game and there is everything that's going to be in the game at the moment already. It just has some bugs, crash issues and... some balance issues still. Like the last mission is apparently almost impossible to play through at the moment because of the mind controlling aliens there. And I may actually have to get the experimental version, which is after this one, to actually play through that mission. It's in this Rayman build state. Yes, it is. Well, if it releases soon, it will be for sale probably, Rayman, so you can maybe get it on a nice sale soon. I think we're gonna reload before we go to the next level. Also, heal the bleeding guys and everything. Doubt sail will be enough, yeah. Probably not for you, Raymond. It's kinda strange that when these Predator armor guys walk through doors, they actually break the door, even if it's open. Just the act of walking through breaks the door. I was wondering, why is Mr. Luchador invisible? But he was actually in the other level. I hope I have enough stun grenades to actually kill the aliens. Ego break door. I guess so. They are actually pretty nice because of that ability. They can just walk through these covers and break them if needed. Because it takes more time units to actually get over that. Okay. That may be the last room, by the way. So I'm gonna go and close the doors. I think that's the pilot. Yeah, that's the cockpit. That's the piloting seats. Yes. And I think the commander alien is up there. Stun grenade is no pokeballs. Well, we are using the electroshock grenades, so they are almost pokeballs, I guess. Babarix doesn't have a grenade, so he doesn't need to go to the door. Pikachu is not the pilot. I guess so. Don't really need all of these guys up here. I hope at least so. This is a pretty neat UFO though. I really like this one. Shame there was not too many aliens in there. Mainly because a lot of them were wraiths, which basically just teleported out and fought me here. That's probably the only thing I don't like about the wraiths. That they pretty much start every map with a huge assault of wraiths that just teleport next to you. Unnerved. Berserking. I think someone shot someone else. Oh well, I'm gonna save here. Cause I don't wanna accidentally kill the leader, if there's a leader. Okay, there's all kinds of stuff here. Those don't look like leaders, though. I think those are just officers. Take me to your leader. Guess we're gonna get... They have a geoscape as well. I think we're gonna get everyone alive then. Excited, I just don't know. Who is the important one? Oh well. Crap throw. What's with these throws? I think I may actually not have enough grenades on these guys. Because these are all our... what? Oh. Why is this not working? Who's hogging the... teleport? You are. Gymstick. These are all our fairly rookies, so they don't have enough strength to actually use grenades that much. Yeah, like no one has grenades on them. Just. Hey, PC Outpost. Oh, Rushdog Raid. Hello, Raiders. Hey, Shotman, McClancy, Recon Hayes. Let's see. Next grenade. Oh crap, I missed so much people. Hey, Tiny Dog, Tater White, Salad White, Generic American, Nitroxin. Hey, Rushlock, thanks a lot for the raid. Hey, Wanderer, Momitsu, Devo, Daddy Gamble, Seacomp, Coming Mansfred, Naku. Hey, Naku. Devin, Rashad. Ah, goddamn. Chat's scrolling. Well, hello. Hello, everyone. It is never ending, yeah, Pat Millard. Thanks a lot, everyone, for stopping by. You're just trying to capture some aliens on a massive UFO for the first time ever. And it's not going too well. One of those guys is a leader I need to capture, I think. Hey, El Bahamut. Bahamut? Thanks for the raid as well. Let's throw another grenade there. Crap throw. At least we got someone. Got a smoke grenade. Let's do a smoke here. Who's next? Yeah, we are out of the guys who have grenades. It just keeps going and going. Hello, everyone. How did Eve go today? What were you guys doing in the Eve? Okay, so there's one more there that I need to capture now. And we have some grenades still left. That's a stun smoke grenade. The other ones I'm throwing around are electroshock grenades. And we have only one left. Crap. So this last grenade needs to stun the alien. At least the alien is not really doing anything as well. Ah, don't shoot it. Don't shoot it! It needs to live. Hey, Papa Man Bear, how's it going? And there goes the grenade. Phew! Got it! Carrier data core, hyperdrive. Ooh, fusion reactor, battle rifle. Ooh, all kinds of new stuff. Alien leader. Oh crap! I actually killed the alien leader. Actually the leader may have been dead from the crash. Ah, that sucks. So this is the one I needed from the UFO. But he was dead, or we killed it at some point already. Oh well, we got 4 new things to research, so there is that. Yeah, Wes, it's getting so much better now that they are close to releasing. Alien battle rifle, fusion reactor and hyperdrive. I think the assault shield, actually. Let's do the assault shield. It was already excellent, and let's throw that away. Battle rifle, two-handed alien weapon, roughly size of a rifle. Advance our knowledge of energy weapons, even more energy weapons. Fusion reactor, hyperdrive, interstellar travel. I'm quite sure this is needed for the last mission. I'm gonna get the guns. So we got a couple of UFOs in there as well. Yeah, no, let's not do it. I was thinking about there is a bug in the game at the moment that if you have multiple UFOs shot down or terror missions or whatever, you can actually do multiple missions by just flying your Valkyrie or whatever your dropship is around. So I did the massive UFO here. I could actually just fly here and do this one as well. And it actually resurrects and heals your guys from the previous mission. And gets everything like it was when you started the flight. So you can do multiple missions that way, but I don't think we are gonna do it this time. Because I don't know what it does with the recharge things. It may ruin my massive loot. What's still grounded. Oh, they actually... Oh, yeah, they almost died. 27, 20, and 22. This was the fleet that shot down the massive, so they almost died doing it. So they need some repair now. Takes forever. I don't think I can actually shoot down those UFOs. That really sucks that the alien leader was dead, or I killed it myself. So this is the very large UFO. It carries pair of interceptor escort craft at launch when the mothership is threatened. No, it didn't. landing ship. I guess that's the biggest UFO, then. Xenopeded sounds dirty. Yeah, it kinda does. But it's a really great feature. I really like that there is this option of having this text here, and you can look at the alien units and what they do, and all this gear and UFOs and everything. That's the basic gray men of this one, Kaizens. Then you have the Andron here, which are robotic units. Light drones, Sebilians, which are kind of like snake men from the original. That's the Kaizen living one. Reaper Autopsy, this is the chrysalid of this game. There's a live Sebilian. Haridans are these strange Ewoks, which are kind of like pilots and snipers of the aliens. Then there's a medium drone and a wraith. These guys teleport around, so they're really fun. I think I'm actually missing something here. Well, at least a lot of live ones. Let's do a save here. Yeah, it is a turn-based rush lock. Small UFO, let's go shoot down that. If only I had ships to do it. How about now? Still grounded. How is the production of the new armors going? Two are done. Ah. Have to wait more. Yeah, definitely. Was like this whole Geoscape was totally redone. It was much worse earlier. Probably has more features than XCOM has. Yeah, I think so, Wes. Oh, another carrier with a escort of heavy fighters. Sebilians on a ground attack mission. Ugh. Hey, Sangneef, how's it going? I want that. Another small UFO. This is a really good change to the, I mean, compared to the new XCOM. UFOs everywhere. It actually feels like an invasion and not just couple aliens coming in different ships. Like, you go through more UFOs in a couple weeks in this game than you go in the whole new XCOM. Another massive. This never happens in the new one. You never see two UFOs at the same time, and I got five now with escort. And another one. Because there wasn't enough yet. Let's do a manual fight. I usually auto-resolve these because I'm crap at killing the UFOs on a manual combat. But there is this whole manual air combat in this game, which I kind of skip totally. And you can control your ships, like, well, this is my three ships. You got a squadron of three. Aliens can have three ships as well, and you can actually decide where this goes and which UFOs to attack. And you can also control the weapons here, so these ones have plasma torpedoes, so I can click them off and not use them if I want to. And here's a afterburner, so you go faster. Evasive roll, so you can avoid missiles, and this is the disengage or retreat. So there goes the missiles. And since it's a small UFO, it kinda dies. Let's go to a mission there. Small Arctic, sure. send in my Valkyrie dropship. Can we... My Marauder is ready. Actually, these are almost ready as well. Repairing. I'm gonna save and try to shoot that down. Which one was this? Ugh. It's an Andron. Andron carrier. I don't want that. To be honest, Androns are one of the worst enemies in this game. Because they are robotic. They have just insane amounts of health. Like the leader units just take so much beating compared to any other enemy.